Hi students, all of you, good morning. In today's topic, we are going to discuss preparation and the properties of ethers. Already in the last class, we discussed the preparation of ethers by dehydration of alcohols. And we understood that the preparation of ethers carries through SN2 reaction mechanism. SN2 means bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reactions. Once again, the preparation of ethers carries through SN2 reaction mechanism. Now, the second method of preparation of ethers is Williamson synthesis. In the Williamson synthesis, alkyl halides are going to react with sodium alkoxides. So what are the reactants in the Williamson synthesis? One is the alkyl halide, second one is the sodium alkoxide. Yes, I'm going to take alkyl halide generally as Rx. Rx is the representation for alkyl halide reacting with sodium alkoxide. Sodium, that is a first A group element, exists in the form of unipositive ion, that is Na plus ion. Alkoxide means alkyl group bonded with oxide, O minus. Alkyl group bonded with oxide, that is the alkoxide. So finally, sodium alkoxide is represented as Na plus O minus bonded with R. This is the sodium alkoxide. Yes, sodium ions react with halide ions. Sodium ions reacting with halide ions, what is going to be removed? Here, removal of sodium halide is going to take place, not the elimination. Here we have to say removal. Removal of sodium halide is going to take place. Due to removal of sodium halide, this alkyl group is going to be bonded with alkoxide. Here the alkyl group gets positive charge. Because X minus is removed, halide is removed, this alkyl group get positive charge. That alkyl group with positive charge is going to react with alkoxide ion. Then we can write R single bond O single bond R. So this is the method of preparation of ethers. And this reaction is called as Williamson ether synthesis. Yes, coming to the point, in the Williamson ether synthesis, what is taken? Alkyl halide is taken. Here, alkyl halide is taken. How many types of alkyl halides are there? Depending upon the halogen attached carbon, the alkyl halides are classified into three types. First degree alkyl halides, second degree alkyl halides, and third degree alkyl halides. Yes, you will get it out. Which type of alkyl halides we have to take to react with sodium alkoxide to get the ethers? Which type of alkyl halides we have to take? Whether we have to take first degree alkyl halides, or we have to take second degree alkyl halides, or we have to take third degree alkyl halides, the question will arise. So we are going to consider three types of alkyl halides to prepare the ethers by using the reaction Williamson ether synthesis. So the topic is Williamson ether synthesis. Remember this one, Williamson ether synthesis. In the name itself, it is there, ether synthesis. Otherwise, simply we can say Williamson synthesis. Williamson synthesis. What are the products of Williamson synthesis? Ethers are the products of Williamson synthesis. And we know that preparation of ethers carries through. SN2 reaction mechanism. Yes, first I am going to consider the alkyl halides. First degree alkyl halides. Example for first degree alkyl halide, ethyl halide. I am taking the ethyl bromide. CH3 single bond, CH2 single bond Br. The compound is called as ethyl bromide. Ethyl bromide, this is an example of first degree alkyl halide. When it is reacting with sodium alkoxide, sodium alkoxide, I am taking the sodium alkoxide, Na plus O minus CH3. What is the name of the compound? Sodium methoxide. The name of the compound is sodium methoxide. So this is the sodium alkoxide. When these two are going to react with each other, here bromide ion is going to react with sodium ions, removed as NaBr. Sodium halide is going to be removed. Sodium bromide is going to be removed. Due to removal of sodium bromide, what we will get? CH3, single bond CH2, bonded with oxygen, bonded with CH3. So we can write the product CH3, single bond CH2, single bond O, CH3, single bond CH2, single bond O, and this oxygen is going to be bonded with CH3. So this is our product. Yes, now we can say that single bond O, single bond is there, that is the ether. And which type of ether? What is the name of the ether? What is the common name of the ether? What is the common name of the ether? This is the ethyl group. This is the methyl group. So the common name of this ether is ethyl. This is the ethyl group. This is the methyl group. Ethyl methyl ether. And we know that it is an example of mixed ether. Mixed ether. What is meant by mixed ether? Having an ether having different types of alkyl groups. Once again, the ether having different types of alkyl groups. The ether having different types of alkyl groups. That ether is called as mixed ether. Right, this is the reaction. Yes, what is taken here? First degree alkyl halide is taken. Suppose instead of taking first degree alkyl halide, if I am going to take a third degree alkyl halide, I am not considering the second degree alkyl halide. I am considering only first degree and third degree alkyl halides. So instead of taking first degree alkyl halide, if we take third degree alkyl halide during the Williamson synthesis reaction, if I take a third degree alkyl halide, example, C, single bond CH3, single bond CH3, single bond CH3, single bond. This carbon is called as third degree carbon, bonded with a halogen. Here the halogen is bromine. So the compound is named as tertiary butyl bromide. Of course, tertiary butyl bromide is also an example of alkyl halide. When this alkyl halide is going to react with what it is going to react? It is going to react with sodium alkoxide. Generally, according to the definition of Williamson synthesis, alkyl halides react with sodium alkoxides. They give us the ether. But here the alkyl halide taken is tertiary butyl bromide reacting with sodium alkoxide. Again, I am taking a simple sodium alkoxide. The simple sodium alkoxide is Na plus O minus CH3, known as sodium methoxide. So mostly the students expect that according to the statement of Williamson synthesis, when alkyl halide reacting with sodium alkoxides, removal of sodium bromide takes place, and this carbon is going to be bonded with oxygen, and oxygen is bonded with CH3. Then we will get the ether. That is our expectation. But here, ether is not going to be formed. In this reaction, ethers are not going to be formed. Why ether is not going to be formed means because we are taking here which type of alkyl halide? Third degree alkyl halide is taken. So whenever a third degree alkyl halide is taken, instead of substitution reaction, elimination reactions will take place. In the last class also I explained the same. Whenever a tertiary compound is taken, that readily undergoes elimination rather than substitution. So this tertiary alkyl halide is ready to undergo elimination reaction. How we can express the elimination reaction? Yes, first we are going to take the tertiary alkyl halide. Tertiary alkyl halide is CH3 single bond C, single bond CH3, single bond CH3, single bond Br. Yes, in the last class I said that when this is going to lose halogen as halide ion, when bromide ion is removed, when this bromide ion is removed, what we will get? We will get a stable third degree carbocation. We will get a stable third degree carbocation. This is the third degree carbocation. A tertiary carbocation is going to be formed. That is, the third degree carbocation is going to be formed. And this third degree carbocation, one of the CH3 group, because all the CH3 groups are same. That is, symmetrical groups are there. Here, one of the CH3 group is going to lose H plus ion. So due to removal of H plus ion between the carbon and hydrogen, this sigma bonded electrons, the sigma bonded electrons between carbon and hydrogen, they are migrated between carbon and carbon. Then between carbon and carbon, single bond becomes as double bond. Single bond becomes as double bond. Then we will get the alkene. What is the alkene? What is the alkene? C, single bond CH3, single bond CH3. Between this carbon and this carbon, single bond becomes double bond. And here it is a CH2. I'm representing like this, CH2. So whenever a tertiary alkyl halide is taken, a third degree alkyl halide is taken, the third degree alkyl halides are ready to undergo elimination reactions. And in this elimination reaction, how many molecules are participating? Only one molecule is participating. This molecule is only participating. There is no sodium alkoxide. Of course, this can react with sodium alkoxide. But before reacting with sodium alkoxide, this tertiary alkyl halide is undergoing removal of halogen and removal of H plus ion. Halogen is removed as halide ion, and H plus ion is removed from. This is the alpha carbon. Because halogen attached carbon is the alpha carbon, adjacent carbon is the beta carbon. From the beta carbon, what is going to be removed? H plus ion is removed. Removal of H plus ion from beta carbon is called as, removal of H plus ion from beta carbon is called as beta elimination. So whenever we are taking the tertiary alkyl halides, there is a beta elimination. Means removal of H plus ion from beta carbon to form the unsaturated compound. What is unsaturated compound formed? Alkene is the unsaturated compound formed. And yes, you will get it out. Of course, it is an elimination reaction. It is an elimination reaction. Elimination reactions are of two types. E1 reaction and E2 reaction. E1 reaction and E2 reaction. What is meant by E1 means? In the rate determination step of a reaction, if only one molecule is participating, then that reaction is called as unimolecular elimination reaction. During the rate determination step of a reaction, if two molecules are participating, then that is bimolecular elimination reaction. In the last class, I explained that when the alcohol reacting with concentrated H2SO4 at high temperature, once again, alcohol, that is ethyl alcohol reacting with concentrated H2SO4 at high temperature, that is 443 Kelvin's temperature, then ethyl alcohol is influencing the speed of the reaction, concentrated H2SO4 is also influencing the reaction, and elimination is happening. That elimination is an example of E2 elimination. In the last class, the first most reaction of the last class, that is an example of E2 reaction, whereas this reaction is an example of E1 reaction. So based on SN1, SN2, E1 and E2, the competitive bits will be asked. Try to solve those. Anyway, coming to, once again, back to the reaction, Williamson synthesis. I am saying that Williamson synthesis, of course, in the Williamson synthesis, we are going to get ethers. The preparation of ethers is an example of SN2 reaction. In the last class also, I explained the SN2 mechanism of dehydration of alcohols. Right, once again, the reaction, Williamson synthesis. In the textbook, in the blue color boxes, blue color box means example problems, solved problems. In the solved problems, the question is given like this. I'm going to share the question. Once check this question on the screen. Yes, on the screen you are seeing one question, that is example problem, example 11.6. Example number 11.6. Are you able to see this one? Whether the screen is shared to you or not? Whether the screen is shared to you or not, text me. Yes, wait a minute, I am going to log in from another mobile. Give me a minute, I'm going to log in. Yes, once read the question, example 11.6, very, very important for a competitive model. The question is very important for competitive model. Example 11.6. Yes. So the question is, the following is not an appropriate reaction for the preparation of tertiary butyl ethyl ether. Once again, the question, the following is not an appropriate reaction for the preparation of tertiary butyl ethyl ether. My dear students, those who are writing the notes, those who are having the notes beside you, please note down the question. Once, please note down the question. Because I am going to open the board. After opening the board, you can't see the question on the screen. Please note down the question. The following is not an appropriate reaction for the preparation of tertiary butyl ethyl ether. I'm giving 1 minute. Please note down. After that, I will continue. Yes, on the board also, I'm writing the same one for the convenient. Question is example 11.6. The following is not, so this is the problem. If I open the board, I can't see the question because I didn't bring the textbook. Yes, just a minute. Okay, once again on the screen, you can see the question. The following is not an appropriate, reaction for the preparation of, for the preparation of tertiary butyl ethyl ether. T hyphen means tertiary butyl ethyl ether. And the reaction is given as C2H5O Na, sodium ethoxide, reacting with tertiary butyl chloride. CCH3, CH3, CH3, C, single bond Cl, that is the tertiary butyl chloride, gives CH3, single bond C, single bond CH3, single bond CH3, single bond O, single bond C2H5. Yes. Now I'm going to open the board. Yes, on the screen, on the board, you can see the same question. First, try to understand the question. Try to understand the question given. The following is not. That means this reaction does not happens. According to the statement, the reaction does not happens. Why? Why this reaction does not happens? Can anybody guess? From this reaction, we can't get the ether. We can't get this ether. Why we can't get this ether? If the class is understood, you can guess the answer. According to the given statement, this reaction is not possible. That means when sodium ethoxide reacting with tertiary butyl chloride, there is no formation of, there is no preparation of tertiary butyl. This is the tertiary butyl group. This is the ethyl group. So what is the compound given? Tertiary butyl ethyl ether. This is the tertiary butyl group. Sorry. This is the tertiary butyl group, this is the ethyl group, and this is the ether. Once again, the name tertiary butyl ether. Sorry, tertiary butyl ethyl ether. Why this is not possible? Yes. Can anybody guess why this reaction is not possible? Tertiary butyl chloride is more stable, sir. Cause elimination dominates substitution. Very good. Correct. Exactly. Karuna. Correct statement. Perfect statement. So here, there is a possibility of substitution reaction and there is a possibility of elimination reaction. Once again, there is a possibility of substitution reaction and there is a possibility of elimination reaction. But this is the alkyl halide. This is the alkyl halide. Which type of alkyl halide it is? Which type of alkyl halide it is? Yes, very good. This is the tertiary alkyl halide. Third degree alkyl halide. The third degree alkyl halides are competing towards the elimination rather than substitution. Once again, the statement, the tertiary alkyl halides are competing with substitution and elimination, but the elimination is more competed than substitution reaction. In a simple language, we can say that the tertiary alkyl halides are ready to undergo elimination rather than substitution. That's why when the elimination is going to happen, elimination reactions gives unsaturated compounds. Once again, elimination reactions gives unsaturated compounds, but here a saturated compound is given. That means this reaction is not possible. Why? Because means the tertiary alkyl halides are ready to undergo elimination reactions rather than substitution reactions. Right. Okay. Now guess. You have to guess. In this reaction, what will be the product formed? Of course, according to the given statement, this product is not formed. Okay, fine. What is the product going to be formed? If both are going to react with each other, what will be the main products? What will be the main products? Can anybody guess? Just now I written on the board. Yes, very good. Exactly. Again, Karuna. Yes, the main product is C, single bond CH3, single bond CH3, C, single bond CH3, single bond CH3. Here, elimination of halogen and beta hydrogen. Once again, elimination of halogen and beta hydrogen. This is the beta carbon. Of course, this is alpha carbon. This is the beta carbon. Elimination of halogen and beta hydrogen is going to take place. Then between carbon and carbon, single bond becomes as double bond CH2. This is the main product. Yes, what is the name of the product? 2-methyl. 2-methylpropene is the product. 2-methylpropene is the major product, but not tertiary butyl ethyl ether. Yes, tell me whether it is understood or not. If it is understood, I can move for the next one. Based on this concept, there are some problems are given in your material MCQs. Sir, please repeat once again. Abhilash Reddy, you are not attending the classes regularly. How you can understand? Because to understand this one, you must attend the class. You have to attend the class alkyl halides. Because of your irregular attendance, how can you understand the class at a time? I'm not going to repeat. You have to go through the videos alkyl halides. That is haloalkanes and halorines. Sorry to say this. If any regular student will ask me, If any regular student will ask me, I can repeat. But being an irregular to the online classes, just listening to the one concept before watching to the previous concepts, before and without understanding the previous concept, how can you understand this concept immediately? Once again, I'm sorry to say this. Anyhow, the point is, once again, I'm sharing the screen. You have to see the question once again. Yes, my dear students, once again on the screen, the same question. Yes, once read the question from the starting. The following is not an appropriate reaction for the preparation of tertiary butyl ether. Okay, Roman number one. What would be the major product of this reaction? Yes, in the question itself it is given. What would be the major product of this reaction? Yes, just now we discussed that 2-methylpropene. 2-methylpropene is the major product of this reaction. Yes, on the screen you can see the answer. Solution Roman number one. The major product of the given reaction is 2-methylprop-1-ene. It is because of elimination reaction is going to happen. Right. See the second question, Roman number two. Read the Roman number two. How much time is there? Okay. Read Roman number two. Write a suitable reaction for the preparation of tertiary butyl ethyl ether. Once again, write a suitable reaction for the preparation of tertiary butyl ethyl ether. What we have to prepare here? We have to prepare tertiary butyl ethyl ether. That means product is given. Tertiary butyl ethyl ether. That is CH3 single bond C, single bond CH3, single bond CH3, single bond O. Yes, tertiary butyl ethyl ether. This is the tertiary butyl group with ether group and ethyl group. Ethyl group is C2H5. So product was given, tertiary butyl ethyl ether. The product is given. To get this ether, as all of you know, to get the ethers, what we have to take? Whether we have to take primary alkyl halides or we have to take tertiary alkyl halides. To get the ethers, whether we have to take primary alkyl halides or tertiary alkyl halides. To get the ethers, whether we have to take primary alkyl halides or tertiary alkyl halides. To get the ethers, we have to take primary alkyl halide. So I am going to take the primary alkyl halide. That primary alkyl halide is, suppose the primary alkyl halide is C2H5Br. C2H5Br, ethyl bromide. I'm going to expand this one, ethyl bromide. Ethyl bromide is represented as CH3. Ethyl bromide is represented as CH3, single bond CH2, single bond Br. This is ethyl bromide. It is an example of first degree alkyl halide. Then, what should be the second reactant? Yes, you can easily guess. This is the ethyl group. Here you can see the ethyl group. So ethyl group with halogen is taken. Here, ethyl group with halogen is taken. That is completed. Next, we have to take the rest of the group. This is the rest of the group. So we are going to take the rest of the group. C single bond CH3. Rest of the group. This is the rest of the group. CH3. Single bond O, this is the rest of the group, oxygen with negative charge, because we have to take here, sodium alkoxide, this is the alkoxide group. What is the name of the alkoxide group? Tertiary butoxide. C, single bond CH3, single bond CH3, single bond CH3, single bond O minus, this group is called as tertiary butoxide group. Nothing but that is the sodium alkoxide. And here, sodium alkoxide means that should contain Na plus Ir. So finally, what should be the reactants to get tertiary butyl ethyl ether? To get the tertiary butyl ethyl ether, what should be the reactants taken? The first one is ethyl bromide or ethyl halide. And the second reactant is, yes, text me the name of the reactant. What is the name of this reactant? What is the name of the second reactant? Text me your answer. During the class, when I'm going to ask you the question, if you are interacting with me, I can understand whether you are understanding the class or not. What is the name of this second reactant? What is the name? Yes, correct. Who's that? Again, Karuna. Chirant, are you there in the class or not? Wait a minute, I had to check the attendance. Chirant, no response. Chirant, once respond. I'm going to open your mic. Every day you are just silent. Yes, just a minute. I will give you the permission. Yes, Chirant, open your mic and talk to me. Just by listening to the class, how can I understand? Because some of the students are keeping the mobile aside and they are watching the IPL cricket matches. Yes, Chirant, respond. If there is no response to my question, just simply I can remove. No mercy is there on any student. No mercy is there on any student.
Hello, sir.
Respond. Chirant.
Yes, sir.
Whether you are listening to the class or not?
Listening, sir.
Why you are not texting any answer? Why you are not giving any response?
I'm copying what you're writing.
Chirant, one thing, every day I'm uploading the PDF in the morning and by the night, every day I'm uploading the PDF. What is the need of writing the class notes in the live class?
I'll get understood, sir.
Okay, fine. Okay, take light. Yes, mute yourself. Okay, fine. Coming to the point. There it is. Yes. So finally, the point is to prepare the tertiary butyl ethyl ether. Once again, to prepare the ethers, one of the reactant must be first degree alkyl halide. And the other reactant is sodium alkoxide. Here, this is the rest of the group. So this rest of the group is included with sodium ions. Once again, my point, this is the rest of the group included with sodium ions. Then we can name this one. The name of the compound is sodium tertiary butoxide. So based on this type of questions, the MCQs are there. Please try to solve yourself, because even though we will solve the MCQs from your material, whatever the material provided by the college, even though we are solving the questions, but those questions never repeat in your competitive examinations. There is no repetition of any question in the competitive examination. So which type of students will get the score means, those are students who can understand the concept, who they themselves can solve the questions, and if they are not able to answer them, you have to approach your lecturer. By discussing with your lecturer, then you will get the subject and knowledge and the concepts very easily. Those the students can only get the ranks. Just by solving the questions from the materials, you can get the answers only, but not the concept. So if you can solve yourself, you will get understand little bit more. So try to do yourself by watching my previous video lectures. Tomorrow, the exam may be conducted by 8 a.m. to 8:45 a.m. Not in any of the class time. By 8 to 8:45, I will send the question paper, and you have to upload the answer sheets by before 9 a.m. And after that, within 5 minutes, by 9:05 or 9:10, I will upload the key sheet. After uploading the key sheet, if any student will send the answer sheets, they are not answered, they are not evaluated. So please try to understand. Please upload your answer scripts by before 9 or 9:05. Right? Is there any doubts? regarding the examination? Is there any doubt? Yes. Once again, those the students who joined lately, please text me in the chat box as present, sir. If the class is not understood, just text me in the chat box. If repetition is required, text me in the chat box, because every day I'm recording the chat, because I want to know the response of each and every student. Nearly 75 students are there in the class now. Please take the attendance screenshot, any of the student, please send it to me. Only less than 1 minute is there. By taking the screenshot, may I miss the attendance, because very less time is there now. Every day I am recording the biology class attendance also. Those the students who are attending the biology class but not coming to the chemistry class, I will remember all of you. I will remember all of you. Yes, thank you for watching to my class. Thank you one and all. Have a nice day. Stay home, stay safe.